Good morning, everybody. I'm Nagajyoti. I came from Government Polytechnic, Parvathipuram. Today, I'm going to say about how to calculate acceleration due to gravity using a simple pendulum. Before that, we need to know what is a simple harmonic motion. So, a simple harmonic motion is the motion of a body such that its acceleration is always directed towards a fixed point, and acceleration is proportional to displacement but in the opposite direction. So, the conditions of simple harmonic motion are, it should be periodic motion, that is the motion should repeat in regular intervals of time, and it should be to and fro motion. Next, the acceleration and displacement should be opposite to each other, and the restoring force acting on the body should also be proportional to the displacement. Now, coming to the examples for simple harmonic motion are the motion of simple pendulum, the oscillations of simple pendulum and torsional pendulum, vibrations of violin string, etc. Now, what is a simple pendulum? So, a simple pendulum is a metal bob suspended by a light inextensible string, is nothing but a simple pendulum. Now, the apparatus required for performing the experiment are a metal bob, split cork, a retort stand, a meter scale, vernier calipers, etc. Now, for starting the experiment, take a split cork, and to the one end of the split cork tie a string, and to the other end of the string tie the metal bob and fix it to the retort stand. Now, from the bottom edge of the rubber cork to the middle of the bob is the length of the pendulum L, and take a pull aside the metal bob with small amplitude. Now, the bob makes oscillations. Now, take a stop clock and take time for 20 oscillations. Count the time for 20 oscillations. Now, it will give the time period. Now, calculate the time period for one oscillation, that is t is equal to small t by 20. Calculate the time period, that is t square in second square, and find the average value of L by t square. And now, substituting the formula, that is acceleration due to gravity, g is equal to 4 pi square into L by t square. So now, the acceleration, we are finding the acceleration. So, the acceleration is nothing but the acceleration acquired by a freely falling body due to the influence of force of gravity.